Afterward, we can visit the mountain and punish the cruel magician of the Flatheads."
"That is sensible," approved the Shaggy Man. "I quite agree with you."
The others, too, seemed to think the Wizard's plan the best, and Glinda herself commended it, so they marched toward the line of palm trees that hid the Skeezer's lake from view. Pretty soon they came to the palms. These were set closely together, the branches, which came quite to the ground, being so tightly interlaced that even the Glass Cat could scarcely find a place to squeeze through. The path which the Flatheads used was some distance away.
"Here's the job for the Tin Woodman," said the Scarecrow.
So the Tin Woodman, who was always glad to be of use, set to work with his sharp, gleaming axe, which he always carried, and in a surprisingly short time had chopped away enough branches to permit them all to pass easily through the trees. Now the clear waters of the beautiful lake were before them, and by looking closely they could see the outlines of the great dome of the sunken island, far from shore, and directly in the center of the lake. Of course every eye was at first fixed upon this dome, where Ozma and Dorothy and the Skeezers were still fast prisoners. But soon their attention was caught by a more brilliant sight, for here was the Diamond Swan swimming just before them, its long neck arched proudly, the amethyst eyes gleaming, and all the diamond-sprinkled feathers glistening splendidly under the rays of the sun. "That," said Glinda, "is the transformation of Queen Coo Ee Oh, the haughty and wicked witch who betrayed the three adepts at magic and treated her people like slaves.